Amber rocks!
So many possible Captain Pino Pineconis to choose from. Oh, which one shall I pick, baby?
Oh, pick a me, Hal.
No, pick a me.
No, pick a me, Hal.
Please pick me. I need it.
Hal, I am the only Captain Pino Pineconi here.
Hey, what's this sticky stuff? Hey, guys, I'm like super stuck over here. Like really, really stucky.
Fear not, Hal, my pal, for I, Nature Cat, shall have you free in a jiff. Squeaks, we are in need of your mighty powers, please.
We're kind of stuck.
What's going on? Okay, we're gonna bust you guys out. This is embarrassing. Daisy,
over here.
Man, oh man, what happened to you guys?
Daisy, help! What is this terrible glue? Tis most unpleasant.
Let's see here. Oh, it looks like the sticky stuff is something the pine tree makes.
You mean, like sap? Like in that episode where we tapped maple trees for maple sap?
I don't think it's sap, Nature Cat. Maple sap is watery and thin. This stuff's sticky and thick. Got it! Says here that pine trees make a really sticky goop called resin. That's it! This stuff must be pine resin.
Gorgeous explanation, Daisy, but do not tell me that we stay glued for this entire episode.
No, that would be kind of boring. Come on, let's wash this resin off you. Follow me.
Water? Why does
it... Yeah, we know about the water thing, Nature Cat, and we understand. But try to relax, man. We're unstuck now.
What she said, baby!
Wow, this stuff is still sticky!
Man, oh man. Sure wish people would pick up after themselves. Hey, what's this? You're kind of pretty. You're even pretty for a piece of plastic junk. Oh, well.
No! Whoa! I found it. Could it be? Could it really, really be? No way. Dave, I don't think this thing is plastic.
What you got, Squeaks?
I think this is big. I'm not sure, but if I'm right, this could be huge. Okay, I gotta find out. I'm gonna split. I'll see you later.
Oh. What's up with Squeaks?
Hal, if you haven't noticed by now, Squeaks works in mysterious ways.
Come on, onward and Squeaksward!
I must know. I simply must know. Tell me your secrets. Tell me! Maybe Daisy was right. Maybe this thing is just a piece of plastic junk.
Tell us, good mouse. What could this thing be if not plastic junk?
Well, I don't want to say it too loud. So I don't want to jinx it. But maybe, just maybe, in a one in a million chance, this little nugget right here could be a piece of genuine
amber.
Amber? Wait, you said Amber, right? I knew it! I just knew it! Oh, I adore Amber. Really, I do. Sigh. And I just have one little quick questiony. What's this Amber stuff, anyway?
Well, it's, Gemmarakama thingy. Definitely.
Oh, yep, I thought so. Gemmarakama thingy. Sounds about right.
Gemmarakama thingy?
Okay, so I don't know what Amber really is. What is it, a rock, a gem, a crystal? I don't know. All I know is Amber's beautiful. I'm hoping this little baby turns out to be the real deal.
Well, Squeaks, none of us knows what Amber really is. So let's see what science has to say.
So, you want to know about Amber, huh? Well, hang on. That's a sticky bit of business. Why sticky, you ask? Well, that's because we need plant resin to make amber.
You mean like pine resin, like the stuff we got stuck in earlier.
Correct, Nature Cat.
But why did the pine tree make resin in the first place?
Great question, Daisy. Only certain kinds of plants make resin. They use it for protection when they get injured, like when a pine tree loses a limb or is damaged by insects or birds. When the resin oozes out of the tree, it hardens and seals up the wound, just like a bandage.
Oh, like for little boo-boos?
That's right, Squeaks.
Well, that is most intriguing. But pray tell, good narrator, sir, what has this got to do with Amber?
Well, Nature Cat, some of the trees that died millions of years ago were buried under water and many, many layers of mud. All that pressure and heat from the layers changed the resin into amber over a very, very long time.
Aha! That sounds like how a fossil is made.
Right you are, Daisy. Those little chunks of resin became fossilized into what we call amber.
So if amber comes from a plant, that means it's not a rock, am I right?
Correct, Nature Cat. Amber's not a rock at all. A real gem, like, wow.
A gem! No way!
Gem! Wow!
Gem, 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 gem.
But wait, it gets better. Occasionally, scientists discover the rarest of rare treasures inside of amber.
Treasure? Like Mr. Chewinski? Or an old sticky sock?
What? That's treasure to me.
Not quite, Hal. These are priceless treasures. For example, scientists have discovered perfectly preserved plants, insects, and even very small birds and animals inside of amber. Like this piece here. Look! It has a leaf from a prehistoric plant inside. And how about this one? It captured a bee that lived millions of years ago. And look at this priceless treasure. Do you know what that is?
No idea, maybe?
Why, that's a perfectly preserved dinosaur tail feather. Now talk about priceless. That's gotta be the rarest of rare things indeed.
Well, that cleared up things nicely. Amber is not a rock after all.
Who'd have thunk it? Thank you, Mr. Invisible Announcer Person Man.
No problem, Hal.
Amber is the coolest thing in the world, but how will I ever know if this one is genuine amber?
Perhaps it's time to talk to a real live expert.
An expert, you say? Like who?
Oh, I have just the right person in mind.
I have prepared three tests that will determine whether your sample is, in fact, genuine amber. Now to the first challenge.